Hi everyone, this is Paul Lang from Discipline Trading Strategies with this week's Trade of the Week video. It's for the week ending 6/13 of 2021. The stock was Wish. It happened on the 8th. That was a Tuesday. This is based on a 60-minute island gap. Kind of a awkward strategy. Worked out well, obviously. 1 minute secondary sign of strength on the entry very early in the morning. Management advance and reward to risk about 8.5 to 1. I want to point out this is an unusual trade. I am showing this one off because it was an exceptional trade, couldn't hide this one. But it's not what you expect, it's not what I go for. It just happened. I had a normal trade, and when I did my afternoon walk away, it just simply took off. I probably never would have captured this much had I been sitting there. Let's take a look at it. First though, DTS free stuff this week, there's nothing. Apologies, other than the bi-weekly scanning night, there's not been a lot of free stuff recently, and that's because I am completing the home study course, first course. It's been a long-awaited project, but does take a considerable amount of time, so that's what's been going on with the free stuff. This is the daily chart for Wish, W-I-S-H. This was only discovered or put on the hot list because it was having a little gap up this day, and you can see the prior day it had gapped down and put in this little tiny doji. Normally, island gaps refer to the daily chart, and it kind of does here, but it's not really a good one on the daily chart, but we're having a little gap up the next day. So we gapped up to there. That's what caught my attention. And I know when you have those little gaps like that, they're called island gaps. They're very rare, but they're powerful reversals. This is not a great example of one, but given the overall chart, the amount was down, I thought it was worth taking a shot if I got a good entry. Had a good entry, so played it, and you can see we have an exceptional bar there. And I didn't get all of that, but a good chunk of it. This is the 60-minute chart where you can see we're going to end up opening right there, clearing most of that day, so I wanted to see some strength for the entry, not weakness in this particular case. And the 60 minute just gives you a good view of the move that occurred that day. Boom, that was the entry, just a little bit off of the open. You can see it better here in the 5. Actually, the stock moves so much, the 5-minute chart is very compressed at the open, so you don't see a whole lot. You'll see on the next chart, the 1-minute chart, the entry a little bit better. But that's where the stock opened, just gapping over most of the prior day. There is the entry right in that area there. You can't see a whole lot. Target 1, just kind of a normal target 1. It was about 1.5 R units, so it was over the goal of the day, just taking it there. But I only took a third off the table, luckily. I did a walk away for lunch, came back as was putting in that red bar. Probably actually would have been better if I never came back, because I thought that was going to be the high of the day for sure. I only took target 2, though, with the hopes that maybe it went crazy. When it set that pivot down here, I then brought up the stop for the last third and walked away till later in the day and came back. And that wide bar there, I ended up taking the last target. It actually went higher into the close. The stop that I had, I mean, almost every dollar is almost 6R, 5R, 6R, and it went another dollar. So there was something left on the table, but certainly no complaints on this one. On the next chart here, you'll get a little better view of the entry. Here's the 1-minute chart. And you can see in the morning here, we opened and we started to move up. Not good enough, though, because this is not a strong stock. It's a weak stock, so you want to make sure that buying is coming into it. So I waited all the way until we took out this high pivot up in here over 8.801, entry at 8.02, stop 7.84. No reason to put the stop anywhere else, because if it were to take out the low of the day, this would have fallen big time probably for the day. So there was no goofing around with it, just high, low pretty much, and it took off. Target number 1, around 10:30. I thought that was a great target. I was thrilled. And then, of course, target 2 and 3 are completely off this chart because this is a 1-minute chart only going till about 11 o'clock. So, again, an exceptional trade. Don't look at this and think this is the way to trade. This is the way losers trade, is going for the home runs like this because they don't come up often enough. I didn't go for the home run. I just got it by accident. So makes for a great trade of the week, but not what you normally are doing here. Bottom line, if you like trades like this in a controlled, organized environment where you can participate, come join us in the DTS trading room. If you hop on over to the DTS website, you'll figure out how to join us if you really want to. This is Paul for DTS. Good trading, everybody.